Salutations to all our future judges. In this video, we are going to see Indian Evidence Act 1872. But before going into the video, I'd like to make few requests to our viewers as well as the subscribers. Kindly do not skip the video. Watch the video from the beginning till the end. If you skip in between, you may be missing very crucial information or very crucial aspects which have been explained. Hence, watch from the beginning till the end. And next request is, please do have a notebook and a pen with you, because various questions which have been asked in Evidence Act in various exams would be mentioned or would be stated. And in addition to this, idea would be given as to how questions could be framed in a particular section. It is very important for you. So you all need to make a note of all these aspects. And in addition to this, some additional illustrations would also be given while teaching the act. Hence, you please make a note of all those additional illustrations as well. They would be of absolute help to you in understanding the particular section. And in addition to this, various ways or techniques would be taught, which would help you to remember those sections, or to say some memory techniques would be given. This would be really helpful to you in remembering the sections when you go to the exam. I hope this video would be of absolute and great utility to you. Judgments of courts of justice when relevant. Section 40. Previous judgments relevant to bar a second suit or trial. Imagine there is a judgment, order or decree given by a court, wherein that order or decree or judgment prevents any court from taking cognizance of a suit or holding a trial. Then it is a relevant fact when a question is arising, or when a question is raised, whether the second court which takes cognizance, or the court which takes cognizance, ought to take the cognizance of such suit or to hold such trial. So put it simply, if a court is restricting another court from taking a suit or a trial, then that judgment which prevents it is relevant. Section 41, relevancy of certain judgments in probate etc. jurisdiction. Now, let us try to understand this particular section by way of a small illustration or an example. Imagine there is a dispute with respect to a property between two brothers. Now the court is saying, it is giving a final judgment, saying that this person or the first brother is the absolute owner of this property, or he is entitled for that particular property. Then in that case, that judgment, that final judgment, is a conclusive proof and it is relevant with respect to such legal character. Now let us try to read this provision and try to understand it further. A final judgment, order or decree of a competent court. So the very important aspect is that it should be of a competent court. So if a court without jurisdiction is giving whether it can be entertained, the answer is absolute no. So the court should be competent enough to give this order or decree. Next, in exercise of probate, matrimonial, admiralty or insolvency jurisdiction. So, with respect to four aspects, probate, matrimonial, admiralty or insolvency jurisdiction. So, under these four aspects, so if the court is conferring any right or any legal character, or it says that a person is not entitled to such legal character, or he is entitled to any particular thing against everybody else. So, now let us take another example. There are five brothers. Now the court is saying the first brother is entitled for a specific right or a specific property, but he is entitled absolutely against all the four. So that is relevant. His special legal character is relevant. Now when that order or decree or judgment is a conclusive proof, when it will be conclusive proof? Generally, as you all know, when a judgment, order or decree comes into operation, from that date, whatever right is conferred becomes a conclusive proof. Or if the judgment, order, or decree states that this order is executable or it comes into operation on a particular day, then from that particular day, that order becomes operational or that legal character becomes valid or accrues to that particular person. And if it takes away a legal character or any right of such person by way of a judgment, order, or decree, then it should happen from the day when the order is passed, or if a day is specified in that judgment saying that it takes away a particular legal character on a particular day, then from that day onwards the legal character shall cease. And if the judgment speaks about entitlement to a particular property, then it shall obviously be entitled, or the person shall be entitled, from the date of judgment, order, or decree, or declares that it had been or should be his property. So if the court is saying this should have been his property, from that day when it should have been his property, from that day onwards he is getting an entitlement. Section 42. Relevancy and effect of judgments, orders, or decrees other than those mentioned in section 41. Imagine a scenario where there is a judgment, order, or decree which is not covered under section 41. They are relevant if they relate to matters of public nature. If they relate to public nature, they are relevant. But these judgments, orders, or decrees are not conclusive proof of that which they state. Let us move to the illustration part of this section. So, A is suing B for trespassing in his land. Now, B is going and saying to the court that, see, this is a public right of way over the land. B is saying this is a public way. I am going in a public way, but A is denying that right. Then, there is existence of a decree in favor of the defendant in a suit by A against C. So, now there are two scenarios where A is filing a case against C for trespassing in his land. Similarly, A has filed another case against C for trespassing on the same land. Now, C has obtained an order or decree in his favor. In that case, the decree obtained by C is relevant, but it is not a conclusive proof that the right of way exists. There is already an order which states that the land or the land in dispute has a public right of way. There is already a decree. But still, that is not a conclusive proof with respect to the case between A and B. Now, let us move to section 43. Section 43 states that those judgments, order, or decree which are not mentioned or which are not covered under section 40, 41, 42 are irrelevant. However, they can be relevant if the existence of such judgment, order, or decree is a fact in issue. Now, the fact in issue in the case itself is that whether such a judgment, order, or decree exists. If that is the question, then it can be relevant. Or it can be relevant if it is covered under some other provision of this Act. If that particular section says that, it is relevant. If some other provision says that, this particular judgment, order, or decree is relevant. Now, let us move on to the illustrations. In illustration A, this A and B, there are two people. This A is filing a case against C. B is also filing a case against C for libel. Now, in both the cases, C is giving a common reply saying that matter alleged to be libelous is true. He accepts that it is true. And he says the circumstances were such that it could be probably true in each case, or it could be neither true in both the case, neither true. So, this A obtains a decree against C for damages. He is succeeding in the case. A is succeeding in the case and obtaining an order against C and is getting damages from C. But this order will not be relevant between B and C. To simply say, it is irrelevant as between B and C. Now, the next question. This question was asked once in a preliminary exam, this particular example. So, please try to understand this in a proper manner. Illustration B says that A prosecutes B for adultery with C, who's A's wife. So, according to A, his wife C had an illicit relationship with B. So, for this, he is filing a case against B. Now, B is saying that C is not the wife of A, but still court convicts B for adultery. Then, sometime after this, this C is prosecuted for bigamy in marrying B during the A's lifetime. So, you should understand, now the wife is coming and saying, the wife is said to have married B actually. Now, she is prosecuted for bigamy. Then again, C also says that I was never the wife of A. I'm not the wife of A. But the judgment against B is irrelevant in this case. It's irrelevant as against C. So, you should understand when a judgment becomes relevant, when a judgment becomes irrelevant. They might give one of these examples and ask you to answer whether relevant, irrelevant, or maybe depending on the situation, depending on the case, or none of the above. They could give options like this. So, you should know which is relevant and which is irrelevant. Now, let us move to example C. A prosecutes B for stealing a cow from him. B is convicted. A is filing a case against B saying that B stole my cow. So, now the court said, yes, yes, B stole the cow and he is convicted. And after some time, this A is suing C. He sues C for the cow. This B has sold this cow to C before his conviction. And now, between A and C, the judgment against B is irrelevant. Now, the court has convicted B, but that judgment is irrelevant with respect to A and C. That is the aspect. Illustration D. A has obtained a degree for the possession of land against B. C. B's son murders A in the consequence. So, this A has filed a case against B and obtained an order in his favor, which is against B. So, now, C, who is the son of B, goes and murders A in consequence. But in this case, the existence of judgment is relevant as showing the motive for a crime. So, you should understand the difference when it becomes relevant, when it becomes irrelevant. Next, illustration E. A is charged with theft and with having been previously convicted of theft. So, now in this present case, he is charged with theft. And in the previous case, he was convicted for theft. The previous conviction is relevant as a fact and issue because it shows that he has been regularly in the habit of doing theft. Previously, he did a theft and he was convicted. Again, now he is charged for theft. So, he is in the regular habit or he is a habitual offender. Let us move to illustration F. A is tried for the murder of B. The fact that B prosecuted A for libel and that A was convicted and sentenced is relevant under section 8 as showing the motive for the fact in issue. So, this A is tried for the murder of B. So, generally, to understand whether it is relevant, if any judgment exists between the same parties, that is very important. This would show the motive that a party or the party has a reason to kill that person. In this particular example, you would see that B has prosecuted A for libel and B has got punishment for A. So, A was trying to seek vengeance against B. There is a possibility or there is a motive for this. So, in that case, the judgment what is given or the sentence what was given becomes relevant and it shows the motive for the fact in issue. Section 44. Fraud or collusion in obtaining judgment or incompetency of court may be proved. Now, let us try to visualize this particular section by way of an illustration or an example. A person is filing a case. Say A against B. Now, the B is coming to the court and saying that, see, there is a judgment which is against A, which is given against A. And it is relevant under section 40, 41 or 42. Then, this person A proves to the court that this particular judgment, what the defendant is showing, what the B is showing to the court, is not delivered by a competent court. or he proves that it was obtained by fraud or collusion, or he proves to the court that there is something fishy about this, which could show that there is a collusion or a fraud. In all these cases, the party A, that is the party who has filed the case, can prove this to the court. And in that case, the power of the judgment will be lost. To put it in a simple manner, a judgment, order or decree obtained from an incompetent court or obtained by fraud or collusion cannot be used against the adverse party. I hope you would have liked the video. If you like the video, please do press the thumbs up button and do share the video with your friends and motivate them. If you are not subscribed to the channel, please do subscribe to the channel and share the channel with your friends. If you feel that I have left something in this video, or you want me to change the way in explanations are given for the sections, please do let me know by way of comments. Let us join hands together and contribute for a learned society. Thank you.